There was none of that outrage on display here at Hooksett District Court this morning. None of the neighbors showed up for the hearing. Meanwhile, Joel Dutton, who has been outspoken about his innocence in the past, had nothing to say this morning.
We have nothing to say to you guys. I told you, put your camera down, you're going to be sued.
As he left Hooksett District Court, Joel Dutton let his wife do the talking. Minutes earlier, the convicted sex offender had been charged with felonious sexual assault upon a 7-year-old girl, an act that allegedly took place at Dutton's home in Hooksett between August 1st and September 6th of this year.
While holding said juvenile on your lap, quote, wrestle with her.
The wrestling, according to the charge, was for the purpose of sexual gratification. In the past, Dutton has said he has a medical condition that makes it impossible for him to do what he is accused of. After he was arrested, Dutton was released on personal recognizance bail, something that outraged his neighbors. It even led to a special meeting of the town council, in which councilors agreed to push for ways to allow police greater leeway in notifying people there is a sex offender in their midst. And now, as you enter the town hall, that list is posted on the door. In court today, the prosecutor asked that the personal recognizance bail be continued, although she did request an additional condition.
The only amendment that I would request is that Merrimack County Pretrial Services be assigned to supervise Mr. Dutton.
And the judge granted that motion. Dutton is due back here November 9th for his probable cause hearing. Meanwhile, a state representative here in Hooksett continues to push for changes in state law that would allow for greater public notification to the public for sex offenders living in their midst. Reporting live in Hooksett, Ray Brewer, WMUR News 9.